there's been this explosion in AI advancements. One thing we've found is that, you know, the average developer is still finding it very difficult to integrate AI into kind of normal applications. And where we see the vision of the future is the companies and applications that are successful will be AI powered. And we want to figure out how we can close that gap so that the developers of tomorrow can leverage AI within their applications. So I'm Phillip LeBlanc, and I'm the CTO co-founder of Spice AI. We make AI accessible through community-driven datasets. I mean, when we created the company, Luke and I, we had this vision of making AI easier for developers. We very quickly kind of focused in on Web3 as an interesting data source for us because Web3 data is this really open data set that anyone has access to. And when we started digging into it, we had this idea that, oh, it's just, you know, the data's there, you can just grab it and, you know, do what you want with it. But what we found is it's actually very difficult to, first, to get the data in real time. Just because running nodes is, you know, can be tricky and unreliable, and also, you know, getting the data in the bulk quantities that you need to train ML. Like, the way we kind of got into it was we wanted to create this kind of example application to, you know, optimize gas fees on Ethereum, because, you know, end of last year the gas fees on Ethereum were, you know, kind of crazy, and we wanted to create this application where what would the gas fees look like over the next, you know, 5 minutes, and so you could make a transaction that. Where you weren't overpaying for gas fees, but you could still get in your transaction. And we spent like the first 90% of like the time for the project just getting the data that we needed to train the model. And it was like 5% was actually training the model, and the other 5% was like making the project. Wow, it's very difficult to get this Web3 data that we just thought was available. So that's where we kind of focused in on, well, if we want people to be able to leverage AI, we need to make it really easy for them to get data. In order to build AI effectively, you need kind of two big components. One is actually the AI algorithm itself, and there's been a lot of work that's gone into developing more and more advanced AI algorithms. I like to think about it like an advanced race car. Like, you can build a better and better race car, but if you don't have the fuel to go into the race car, the car is not going to go anywhere. And it's the same thing with AI. You can have the most advanced kind of AI algorithm, but if you don't give it the data, which is the fuel for AI, it's not going to do anything useful for you. And so I think a lot of people, like, at least I did when I first got into the space, underestimated kind of the importance of like a data and being able to process it into kind of the right format. Because AI algorithms, they need data in kind of a very specific way in order for it to work well. Another analogy we use is like the data is kind of this like crude oil, which is not very useful by itself, and you need to refine it and process it into something more usable that you can actually give into an AI algorithm. And at Spice, we kind of do both parts. We actually extract, so if going back to the crude oil analogy, we actually extract the oil from the ground, if you will, where we run our own kind of blockchain nodes and we extract the data from the blockchain, you know, as it comes out. And then we also do the processing on top of it, and we process that data into kind of what we call higher order data sets, which are more useful for people. And then eventually we want to get to the point where you can create your own data sets on top of the raw data that we have. And so you can, if you have a very specific need to have it in a, you know, one format, you would be able to run that processing in Spice, create a data set, and be able to use that. And so we really want to go to this place where we have community-based data sets, where someone in the community can take the raw data, create this interesting data set, and share it with the rest of the community, and potentially get incentivized for doing that as well. At Spice AI, we've been developing a data platform where we index data in real time from blockchains that we support. And some of our customers have found this useful for developing their ML models. And so in one example we have is our customer is Yakoa, and they're doing NFT fraud detection. In NFT fraud detection, you need to know first, what are all the NFTs that exist on the blockchain? And at Spice, we index the NFTs in real time. And so as soon as a new NFT pops up on the blockchain, we index it and make that available for them. And so they can run their models, you know, as new NFTs come up in real time. And another thing that's useful is just getting the list of NFTs. I think on Ethereum today, there's like over 90 million NFTs on the blockchain, and there's no other service provider that provides access to all, you know, 90 million in one go. So there's other service providers that where you can get, you know, kind of similar data, but not at the same level and the same intensity. So just the bulk data scenario, which is really important for ML, because you need to be able to have lots of data to train ML. And at Spice, we provide that. One of the long-term goals of Spice AI is to really, like, help humanity in one of the ways we want to do that is make it cheaper for people to get access to really good quality healthcare. We thought AI was a really interesting way we could do that, because you can imagine that a doctor in like India or a doctor in the US, they have the same knowledge and they have like a lot of the same experience. And so they can both look at, you know, for example, an MRI and say, you know, this is a broken bone or, you know, whatever, but at different, way different price points. And so if there was a way we could, you know, encode that knowledge through an AI mechanism, we thought there was a way that we could, you know, drive healthcare costs way down in kind of developed countries. There's a science fiction series called Dune, and in Dune, one of the elements is spice, which is supposed to be this thing that can, you know, give you a lot of health benefits and make you live longer. And so that was kind of where the name came from. The way that I'm looking to put a ding in the universe, I think there's kind of two aspects for it. There's one with the work that I'm doing with Spice AI to make, you know, AI more accessible to developers and eventually go into kind of the healthcare, but also just be an example to, I guess, the people in my life and, you know, other kind of aspiring founders that might think, oh, like, how can I do this? Like, I'm the most normal person in the world. Before I went into the startup, I would have considered myself to be like the least qualified person to start a startup. I was like big tech, like working at Microsoft for almost 10 years. Like, how do you go from that kind of straight into the startup world? And there's definitely been a lot of growth and learning from that. And just like showing people that, yeah, it's possible, you can do it. Like, and if I can inspire at least one other person to start a startup, I think that would be an amazing.